How to choose an apartment dog. Living in an apartment shouldn't prohibit you from getting a dog and enjoying your life together. However, there are many things to consider before making your decision, from consulting your landlord to researching breeds. Taking the time to think about your current lifestyle and what accommodations you can make for your dog will give you both a comfortable and happy life. Part 1. Selecting the right dog for you. Choose a dog based on their size. Not all dog sizes are fitting for an apartment. Looking for smaller dog breeds will ensure that your dog remains comfortable in their new home. Even if you are getting a puppy, it is important to choose a breed that won't grow too big. Ask your local animal shelter or kennel for recommendations on smaller dog breeds. Chihuahuas, pugs, bulldogs, and terriers are popular small dog breeds. Select a breed based on temperament. Choosing a dog that has a calm and quiet temperament will keep your dog comfortable and keep you from having to walk them every hour. Even though you want to tend towards smaller breeds, not all small breeds have calm and low-energy temperaments. Consult different websites and blogs online devoted to living in apartments with dogs. 3. For information on different breeds, go to www.akc.org. Some popular low-energy dog breeds are Spaniels, Beagles, Bulldogs, and Corgis. Choose a quiet breed. Living in an apartment means that you will inevitably have neighbors. Choosing a quiet dog that does not react and bark at every sound, noise, or movement they detect will keep both you and your neighbors happy. However, keep in mind that many smaller toy breeds can often be noisy. Pugs, bulldogs, and whippets are known for being quieter, smaller breeds. Be sure to avoid guardian breeds. Guardian breeds are most likely to be territorial and react to almost every noise and movement. Common guardian breeds are Boxers, Rottweilers, Dobermans, and German Shepherds. All dogs vary, even if their breed is known for being quiet. Consult your shelter to see if the specific dog you are considering is actually quiet. Choose an adult dog. An older dog that is past its puppy and young adulthood stage could also make a great apartment dog. Dogs of this maturity level are likely calmer than younger dogs. This means that they may make less noise, have less energy, and require less space and exercise. Select a dog that is sociable. Dense urban areas and cities can come with a large range of noises and people. The more sociable your dog is, the easier the transition to an urban lifestyle will be. Sociable dogs will also be more likely to engage with other dogs that they come across without displaying aggressive behavior. Consult your shelter or adoption agency about your dog's adoption history, if they have displayed aggressive behavior before, and what the circumstances were. Ask questions like, what quiet breeds would you recommend for an apartment? Or, is this particular dog generally quiet? On what occasions do they bark? Go to your local kennel or animal shelter. Go to your local animal shelter with questions about ideal dogs for apartment living. Some dogs, even larger ones, might have low-energy temperaments. Although breed is important to consider, meeting your dog and making sure you have a connection is just as important. Ask questions at your local shelter, like, what smaller breeds would you recommend for an apartment? How often should I exercise this breed? Or, is this breed generally known for being quiet? Consult your local animal shelter for any other informational resources they might have for keeping a dog in an apartment. Part 2. Making your apartment dog friendly. Consider your landlord's pet policies. Be upfront with your landlord about your desire to get a dog and ask about their pet policies. You will more than likely need to provide papers proving your dog's registration and vaccination records. Some landlords might have restrictions on which breeds are allowed in your building or how many pets you are allowed to have in an apartment. You may also be required to pay an additional deposit. Dog-proof your home. Taking the interior of your apartment into consideration when choosing a dog is essential to providing a safe and friendly environment for them in your home. Make your apartment dog friendly and safe by dog-proofing lower cabinets and drawers. Scan your apartment for outlets and low-hanging wires that your dog might be able to chew on. Create a crate space for your dog by getting them a dog bed and crate and placing it in an uncluttered and clean location. Corners of bedrooms and living rooms make for great crate spaces. Research dog-friendly parks and areas around your apartment. You'll inevitably need to leave your apartment, and the more you can bring your dog with you, the better. Looking around your apartment for dog-friendly areas will provide you with alternatives for exercise and play. Look for nearby dog parks, public spaces, or outdoor areas of restaurants and cafes to bring your dog to. If you are isolated in a dense urban area that does not have any local dog parks, consider enrolling your dog in a daycare program so that they can get the socialization they'll need. Buy your dog mentally stimulating toys. Keeping your dog busy inside your apartment is just as important as keeping them busy outside your apartment. Try using stimulating dog toys to engage your dog's senses and mental faculties. Stimulating dog toys will help keep your dog engaged, occupied, and happy. Try using multi-sensory treat dispensing dog toys, like Orca Chew, to keep your dog entertained and stimulated. Consider hiring a pet sitter. Take into account your daily schedule, how often you travel, and if you know any other dog owners. All dogs, whether in an apartment or house, need consistent attention and care. Understanding the demands of your lifestyle will allow you make adjustments to give your dog a happy and comfortable life. Hire a pet sitter if you have a demanding work schedule, need to travel for days at a time, or can't get out of social obligations. Ask yourself questions, like, am I able to adjust my schedule to make sure my dog gets the attention and care they need? Or, are there any parks or open areas I can take my dog to for exercise and play? Don't forget like and subscribe my channel and click on bell button for more videos.